Good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. I hope that you all would have sincerely learned about the advanced options of Impress in this module. This advanced module will end here. In the next class, you will all appear for a practical test. And then you will appear for a written test to be conducted by Computer Shiksha. In today's class, you will all revise some of the options that you have been taught in the advanced part of Impress. Can you say why is the interaction option used? Interaction option is used during a slideshow. Since there are many options available in this, so you can use the option as per your need. Do you know why is the slide transition used? With the help of the slide transition, you can apply special effects on your slides, like you can define the speed of your slideshow. You can provide a list of the sounds to be applied during the slideshow or when changing to the next slide, etc. Can you tell why is the minimize presentation used? Using this option, you can reduce the size of your presentation. You can compress your image files and you can see a summary of your Impress presentation. Can you say why we use the slide design option? Using the slide design, you can change the design of your slide. Now, all of you switch on your computer and using any of the methods taught to you, open the Impress file. Let us now know what you will be learning today. In today's class, you will be revising the options for rehearse timing, custom animation, color replacer, area, summary slide, expand slide, master pages, properties, templates, hyperlink, grid, and direct print file. So let us now begin today's class. Firstly, go ahead and insert 4 slides. Make sure that each slide has a different design. In the first slide from the layout, choose title slide layout and then type out the given paragraph about Computer Shiksha. Next, show how you will use the bold, italic and font color formatting on one of the lines. If you are having a problem, then you may learn from the videos being shown to you. Let us watch this video now and see how we can apply different slide designs in our slides on the Impress file and also how to format. So first we have to get some new slides. Click on the slide pane, right click, choose new slide. Keep doing this until you have 4 slides. Now select the first slide. We want to change the slide design, so right click on it and then choose slide design. Once the slide design box opens, click on load, choose the presentation background and then choose any of the backgrounds that you like. There is a template here, click on OK and you can see in the preview window it gets applied. Now since exchange background color has not been ticked, it will only get applied to this slide. So the moment you click OK, you can see it has got applied. Go to the second slide, right click, select slide design, click on load, select presentation backgrounds, select one of the backgrounds that you like and then click on OK. You will see the change in the preview window. Once you click on OK, you can scroll up and down, choose the one which you like. You will see this applied in the preview window and then you click on OK in the slide design box and you can see that this design has got applied to your slide. Go to the third slide, right click on it, click on or choose the slide design option. From the box that opens, click on load, select presentation background, choose a presentation that you like, choose a background that you like, click on OK, and you will see in the preview window it gets applied. And when you click on OK in the slide design, it gets applied on your slide also. So this way you can apply different slide designs on different slides in your Impress file. Fourth slide, right click, click on slide design, click on load, again choose presentation background from the categories and choose one of the background options that you like, click on OK, and if you scroll down in the slide design window, you can see that it has been applied in the preview. Click on OK and it gets applied on your slide also. Now we have been asked to format the text of the first slide. So we select the first slide, select the contents area, and then select the text that we want to change the format for. So once we select the text using any of the methods that you know, we can click on bold in the format menu bar. Format menu, click on bold, it becomes bold. Once again, select the text. If you want to make it italics, you can either use Ctrl plus I shortcut command or click on the I button in the format menu. You can also click on underline, so you have made it bold, underlined, and also italics. So this way you can continue to do formatting on the text. Now if you want to change the font color also, you can do that also. You can do all the formatting that you like on this slide. So once again, if you want to change the font color, you will need to select the text here as is being shown in the video to you. Select the text once again, and then in the format menu, click on the A option or the A button, which is for the font color. Click on the drop down button and choose a color of your choice. So you can see that you have done all the formatting. You've done bold, italics, underline, change the font color. So this way you can insert new slides, apply different slide designs on the slides, and also format the different options. Have you all been able to complete the tasks you were asked to do or no? Now all of you apply custom animation on all the slides so that your text appears in a style and all the pictures that you have inserted also get shown with different effects, and then show it to your teacher. If while applying custom animation you have any doubts, then watch the video. Let us now watch this video and once again practice the use or application of custom animation. So we first take our slide, choose the next slide, and we make it blank. On all these slides we will apply some custom animation. So in this slide we don't have any image, so we have chosen from the drawing toolbar a smiley face and we have applied that. Choose the next slide, again make it blank layout, go to the drawing toolbar, choose one of the shapes there. We have chosen a scroll and we drag it and make it here a scroll, and from the properties we can change the color also. We can insert fill color with the color of our choice as is being shown in the video. Go to the next slide. Again here we have a title slide. We can make it a blank slide layout, or let's see what happens if we leave it as a title slide. Now we have clicked on title. Let's go to insert and insert a picture. choose picture, insert from file, and choose a picture of your choice. As soon as you click on open, this picture gets inserted on the slide. But since we had chosen only the title area, it gets inserted there. This is not something we want. We want the whole picture on the full slide. So we delete this, make it into a blank layout, go back to insert and click on picture option and click on the from file option and choose our picture from the desktop and click on open, and this gets inserted on our slide. Now we have all these four slides with different images and different text on it in the slides. We want to apply custom animation. So let's choose the first slide and let's choose the title, which is written here, only you can change yourself. We select that, and then you have the add option appearing in custom animation. You can click on that, and then you can choose one of the animations that you like. As soon as you select, you will see it being applied on your slide. You can also change the speed of the animation. You can make it fast or normal or whatever speed you want to choose. Click on OK. Choose the next slide. Choose the image in the slide. Click on add, and then choose one of the animation styles. Again, if you want, you can choose to vary the speed also. You can keep the speed that you like. Very fast, fast, slow, so on. Click on OK. Choose the next slide. Choose the image on the slide. Click on add. As is being shown in the video, click on the animation of your choice, and again choose the speed that you want to apply. Click on OK. Now we go to the fourth slide. Click on the image there, select the slide, click on add, click on the animation of your choice, also set the speed that you like. Once you select these animations, you can see them on your slide. So you can then choose which you like. After setting the speed, click on OK. Now we have applied custom animation on all of these slides. Go to the first slide and you can run your slideshow by using F5. And once you use the scroll down arrow, you will see all these changes happening. The custom animation gets applied and is being shown to you. The second slide. Then it goes to the third slide, and all the animation that you had applied with the speed that you had applied is being shown to you in the slideshow. So this is how you will use custom animation option to apply on your slides in the Impress file. Now go ahead and insert a new slide and insert some picture on it and then change their format. Watch this video to practice the use of formatting on our slides and also using the color replacer. So for doing this, we first want to insert some new slides. So take your pointer to the last slide because we want to insert the new slide after that. Right click on it, click on new slide option, and you have a new slide which is in the same design as the fourth slide. Now if you want to make this a blank layout, go to the layouts option and click on blank. So you have this, you have made it blank layout. Now to make an image or a drawing, from the drawing toolbar we choose an object which we want to make here in this slide. So we are choosing flowcharts, one of the options in flowcharts, and then drag it here to make the image. So once the image has been made, now you can change its format by using the line and formatting toolbar. Select the object, let's change the color inside. We are choosing bitmap, and then from the drop down button here, we choose one of the designs. So we are choosing something like the bricks, and it shows here. Let's also change the outline of this image. So click on this drop down button, choose the outline. We've chosen black, so you can see that happening. So we have inserted a new picture and we have made some format changes on this. Now if you want to choose color replacer and see to practice it, let's choose one of the slides where we have some image. So we can choose this or choose any of the other slides where we want to use color replacer. And then we will select one of the colors that we want to replace in that image. So we've chosen this fourth slide. And since we want to choose use the color replacer here, we select this image, select this slide, and then go to the menu bar. Let's try to see what happens. So we go to tools and click on color replacer. A box opens which shows you options for which color you want to choose and with what you want to replace it. There is also a pipette. So first select the pipette and then point to the color that you want to change. For instance, we are pointing to a color here, this one that we want to change. Click on it and it comes in the first rectangle there, and then you have a replace with option. So you can scroll up and down and choose the color with which you want to replace this color. So after choosing that color, you will click on replace. So we've chosen this greenish color. Click on replace and you can see that in the slide on that image your color gets replaced. So this way you can insert a new slide, make images on it, and also change the format of the image or the object and use the color replacer option. Now go ahead and practice the use of slide transition on all the slides. Watch the video if you have a doubt. Watching this video, we will now see how we can have slide transition effects applied on our slides. To apply the slide transition effects, we first need to choose our slide transition we choose, and then we can go to the first slide because we want to apply on all slides. We've chosen the title area to apply the effect. Choose an effect of your choice. Then if you want, you can apply a sound also with this effect. So as the slide transitions, the effect will play and the sound will play. We choose the second slide, apply an effect which we like. You can see when you select the effect, you can see it being applied on your video, on your slide, so you can choose the one which you like. Then you choose the sound. Right now we are looking at recorded videos, so the sound is not audible to you, but when you apply it on your slide, you can also hear the sounds. We've gone to the third slide. Again we choose one of the effects, choose a sound, and it gets applied on this slide. Then we choose this slide with an image of a desert. Again, we have chosen this slide and we choose one of the effects, slide transition effects, which we want on this slide. You can see different effects by selecting. It will show on your slide. So the one which you like, you apply that, or you select that, and then you select a sound to go with this slide transition. So when you play a slideshow, this sound and the slide effect, transition effect will be shown. We've gone to the next slide, applied another effect here for slide transition. We're scrolling down to see what other effects we can use. So we can use one of these effects. You can see how it applies. And then we choose a sound also. So now that we have applied the slide effects for slide transition and the sounds, we can go to the first slide and begin our slideshow by using F5 as the shortcut command. and then use the scroll down arrow, and you can see all these changes happening. It goes to the next slide. In the first slide, it was applied to the title. In the second slide, it's applied to the image. So when you run this, the slide transition effect as well as the sound effect will be applied, and you can hear those changes and see the slide effect also happening. So this is how you will use slide transition option. Next, show how you will use the summary slide and also tell what happens with this. If you face a problem in making the summary slide, then watch the video and learn about it. In this video, let us see how we can get all the titles of our slide presentation into one summary slide, how we can form a summary slide. So in the first slide, we already have a title, but in the next slide, we only have an image. So we want to give a title to this shape. We go to the layout option, click on the title slide, and then in the title area, let's add a title for this slide. So for this image, we have written smiley. Let's go to the next slide. Again, let's go to layout and change this to a title slide and click on the add slide title and then give it a title. So if we want, we can write notes, or if we want a different title to this, it's up to us and up to you to give a title to this. So we are saying a diary. So we have given a title to this now. The next is a picture. So what we have done is we have given titles to three slides. The first, second and third slide. You can see there are titles here. Now if we want to take a summary slide, we will go to the insert menu and choose the summary slide option. As soon as you choose the summary slide option and you scroll down on your slide pane, you will see that a new slide has been created, which is the summary slide. Click on it and you can see that all the titles of the three slides that were there in this slide presentation have been created on the summary slide. This is how you use the summary slide option. Next, show how you can use the summary given in the summary slide to change it into titles of each of your slides. Watch the video in case of problems. In this video, let's see what happens when we use the expand slide option on the summary slide. So we want to bring all these titles which are appearing on the summary slide into separate slides. So we use the options available in the insert menu and click on the expand slide option. As soon as you click on the expand slide option and you scroll down on your slide pane, you will see that the three new slides have been made now, each having a title: a diary, smiley, and the first slide, which had a title which was already there, only you can change yourself. So this is how you can change the summary slide into separate slides with each title. Again, insert a new slide and then from your desktop or from a document on your computer, show how you will insert a different file. Instead of the file address, the name of that file should appear in your slide. In case of a problem, watch the video. In this video, we are going to practice the use of linking another file to our Impress slide or Impress file using hyperlink. You can do so in two methods, using the insert option or the hyperlink icon in the standard toolbar. In the insert option, click on the hyperlink option and click on this open link here, which shows you where your files are. So you can select from where you want to take the file. We have selected the desktop. and then we select one of the files which we want to link there. So we are selecting the Impress class 1 file, a PDF file. We click on that and then we click on open. You can see that these links appear. Now if you want that instead of the link appearing on your slide, Impress slide, a name should appear, you can type in the text box your name or any the name that you want this hyperlink to appear with. It can be your name, it can be the file's name. We are typing Computer Shiksha here. Then you have to click on apply. But here when we click on apply, you see that those links have disappeared. So let's do this once again. Click on open. Click on the file that you want from the desktop. Click on open here. Now the links are there. Type the name that you want this hyperlink to appear by. We are typing Computer Shiksha. Click on apply. The links should stay there. As is being shown in the video, the links are there. Then you click on close. Now you can see the hyperlink has been applied in this. You can't see it because right now this is a title slide. So let's choose the content, select the contents and delete that. And now you can see the link applied here. So if you click on the link, use the control button and left click, this file will open. The hyperlink file will open and you can see the file. You can work with this if you want while you are still using your Impress file, original file. So this way you can apply a hyperlink. You can close this. You can apply a hyperlink and give it a name of your choice also. Now with the help of save on desktop option, save your file in MS PowerPoint. In case you face a problem in saving in MS PowerPoint, then watch the video and learn how it is done. Let us watch this video now and see how we can save our Impress file in some other format. If we want to change the format of the file, we can do so. For this, go to the file menu, click on that, and then click on the Wizards option. In the Wizards option, select the Document Converter. And from the box that opens, since you want to convert into Microsoft Office, we select Microsoft Office, PowerPoint documents, because that is what we want to do. We want to convert it to this format. Click on Next. And then, since from the templates, we do not want to select the PowerPoint templates, we deselect that, unselect that, and we have selected the documents, PowerPoint documents. Now here, from this icon, you can import any file that you want to convert. You can click on this and then you can import a file. Also, the other icon tells you where you want to save it. So you can select desktop as a place where you want to save it. Click on OK. And then click on Next. After this, in the next box, you can click on Convert so that your document gets converted and close. So this way you can use these options of the wizard to convert your file. If you want to see your file, you can reduce this current file that you're working on, and on the desktop you can see that your file has been properly converted and saved. So this is how you will use this option. Now tell about your file size, the location of the file, file data, etc. And then let us watch the video to see if you are answering this correctly. Let us now watch this video and see how we can use the properties option to know more about our file. Things like when was this saved, how many pages are there. So all such information you can get from the properties option. Click on file menu and click on properties. Choose the properties option. A box opens and you can click on the general tab where you will see the title of the file, the type of the file, which is open document presentation. It shows the location where it has been saved. It shows the size. When was this file created? When was it modified? So all this information is available here. So you can get all kinds of information about your file by using the properties option. Since this class will end here, close your file and then properly shut down your computer. In today's class, you have revised the advanced options of Impress. You should all remain present for the next class. As you all know, in the next class, you will all appear for a practical test. If any student remains absent for the practical test, then that student cannot appear for the written test to be conducted by Computer Shiksha. Also, we from Computer Shiksha want to thank all of you students for dedicatedly learning about computers through these videos developed by Computer Shiksha. We also wish you all the very best for your future. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Thank you.